How's he doing since the surgery?
The eye looks great.
Personally, I've seen him in leaps and bounds from where he came from originally.
At the park the other day, I don't know if it was because he was wearing a baseball hat or the sun or but a lot of tilted.
We've made some progress. Mm-hmm. We had our first surgery and our second, and we're making progress, but we still have a little more progress to go. I think I was always a scientist from a young person. I always enjoyed science in high school and in university. And in terms of ophthalmology, I was very attracted to the field because there's so much we can do to take care of patients. If we can fix something for a child, we're giving them a whole lifetime of something better than they might have had had it not been fixed at that point. I'm Dr. Linda Dagi. I'm the director of Adult Strabismus and the consultant for craniofacial ophthalmic disorders at Boston Children's Hospital. So here's Patrick when he was younger. Take a look at the size of that head tilt he had. As I see him now, he has some residual head tilt. Definitely improved. Definitely improved. Strabismus is misalignment of the eyes. You might know if your child had strabismus just by looking at them, because you would find that they have poor eye contact, good eye contact with one eye, but the other eye seems to wander in or out or up or down. For the patients that I see that are young, I follow them for many years. Sometimes they may need to have more than one procedure done to manage their ocular misalignment, and so we follow them through their adult years, oftentimes into entrance into college. The adults we see more sporadically, they're often sent to us by other specialists, and we try to address their problem, fix their double vision, fix their alignment, and then oftentimes they go back to their adult subspecialist. One of the things I really love about strabismus surgery is that we can fine-tune the work we do with something called adjustable sutures, basically attaching the eye muscles that we need to move to suture material and gently separating them from the eye and placing them right back on in a better place. When the patient wakes up, sometimes we find the alignment's a little different than we saw when the patient was under anesthesia, and we can then fine-tune the alignment we see based on the appearance of the child or the adult once they're awake.
How have you been doing since your surgery?
Great. I've been doing great. It's really been life-changing. I really was so self-conscious because it was such a struggle for me to really keep my eyes together and to look someone in the eye.
Boston Children's is a really special place. The ancillary support staff that we have the opportunity to work with are superb. I feel when I take a patient here and I'm caring for them that I have all the help I need to take the best care of the patient.